Thank you very much. So I will talk about guided waves and clinical measurements in bone. So the context of this study is osteoporosis. Which is a progressive bone disease characterized by the pathological bone remodeling, which can lead to an increased risk of fracture. So you can see here two different bones measured in micro CT. This one is quite regular, and this one is more porous and due to osteoporosis. The current golden standard is TXA, and try to access both structural and material bone decay in order to identify women at risk of fracture. And for now 15 years, ultrasound have been proposed to assess also cortical bone, mainly using the fast velocity. So what is fast for the false arrival signal? If you put a transistor here on the radius, for example here, and you receive here, you send a classical pulse, what you receive is a very long response due to all the reflection at the cortical bone, which behaves like a waveguide. And the fast is the first arrival signal, the beginning of the signal. And it has been measured in several clinical studies. And the idea now is to exploit, to analyze the whole signal, to extract useful information about cortical thickness and porosity. And the goal of this study, and to test it in the pilot clinical study, and to see if we can discriminate between fracture and non-fracture postmenopausal women. So to this end, we have developed a specific material which consists in an electronic device and a probe. And the probe is like this, with two array of transmitters and array of receiver in the middle. So we can record this type of signal, which with multiple transmitter, multiple receiver in time versus space. And we have developed a specific signal processing, which is very similar to 2D Fourier transform. So from time we go to frequency, and from space to K, the wave number, which is a spatial frequency. And you see, if you do a normalized 2D Fourier transform, you see some lines here. That's the dispersion of the wave number, dispersion curve of the mode. And with all signal processing, using all the transmission, we can have a better image, so-called norm function. You see, with less noise, and the modes are in the 0-1 scale. Zero is blue, no mode, red, there are a mode. And it can be done in real time. So to exploit, to analyze the data, we need a model, a waveguide model. So today, to this day, we are using this model. It can improve in the future. It's a 2D transverse isotropic free plate. And the material is homogeneized porous material depending on porosity. So if I move the thickness here, for example, you see 1.2, 1.3, 1.4 millimeter, this mode moves like this. If I move the porosity from 1, 10, 20%, it's very similar to this. But if I can also measure A0, for example, I am able to measure both porosity and thickness. And this approach has been validated on phantom, on ex vivo radius, and healthy people. So that's an example of ex vivo measurement. You see here the norm function is not as clear as a metallic plate, but still we can see some line if we take the maxima here, and we can find without too much problem the best fitting model, and we have here a cortical thickness and a cortical porosity. If I do this now in vivo, it appears much blurry, but if you see the lines here, we can still fit a model, and this mode, for example, S2, is very similar to this one because the thickness are quite similar, 2.3, 2.8. And also we can measure the A0 mode. And from this slope, we extract a velocity called VA0. Okay, so the patient now. We have measured 15 healthy women from 25 to 55 years old as reference and comparison, and more than now 200 postmenopausal women with some are without fracture, some with are with non-traumatic fracture. The ratio is about 40%, and the age is from 45 to 95 years old. And we are doing the current gold standard, the DXA, so at the femur and at the spine, and the gray level give us the bone mineral density. Okay, and the analytic tool would be the logistic regression to discriminate the two groups. Okay, so here are some results. First, the VFAS, the first IRVing interval. So that's here, age from 25 to 90 years old. In black, that's the 15, I would say, healthy people. And in blue, the people from the clinical measurement. And what we can say, we have a small tendency here with decrease with age, and that's the rho here, 0.34. It's a Spearman coefficient. Now we have the same tendency for VA0, the healthy people, and a decrease with age. Okay, if I look now at the cortical thickness, still the same axis, age, healthy people, and a decrease with age from 3 to 4 millimeters to 1 to 2 millimeters. And the cortical thickness, we have a small tendency with age, which is increasing. Okay, so now if I want to discriminate the two groups, if I do some logistic regression analysis, I will have two parameters. First one is odd ratio. It's an estimation of the effect of the factor measured, for example, the thickness of an event, which is the fracture. And the AUC is the area under the receiving operating characteristic or ROC curve. It's the performance of the classifier. If it's one, the performance is bad, and the larger, the performance is good. So that's the current analysis. It will be surely improved in the future. So we have four ultrasonic parameters, two velocity, the cortical thickness, and the porosity index. Two are non-significant, the FAS and the thickness. Two are significant, the A0 and the porosity. And the value here, 1.4, 0.74, are very close to the gold standard, the DXA at the femur. And the lumbar spine for this porosity, it's also non-significant. And that's age-adjusted value. So to this day, we can say that we are very similar to the gold standard. So, but as a description, can we make things better or have more information? The idea that we are in a 2D plane. We have the cortical thickness and the cortical porosity. So I have put some red points here, which are the fracture people, and some blue point here. That's the first people of the clinical trial, just as an illustration. So the idea is here, for example, these blue points are thick bone and with a small porosity. That's bone like this. And that's where the healthy people are. But you can have this type of bone, which are quite thick and porous, and this type of bone, which are thin, about 1 millimeter, and with small porosity. So maybe the place in this plane could be useful for the clinics, but it has to be investigated and discussed later. And also, we have some limits. We have about 10% failure for the ultrasound, and it's mainly due to the thick soft tissue layer, body mass index larger than 32. And it has been previously seen on other clinical studies. And also, we have about one-third difficult to measure, difficult to fix a model. And if you see bone like this, it's highly irregular, so the waveguide assumption is very questionable. So here, we don't have any problem to measure. Here, it's more complicated. Okay, so as a conclusion, I would say we have measured more than 200 people know in this clinical study, we are able to estimate four parameters: two velocity, the velocity of the first arrival signal, the velocity of the fundamental guided mode, and we extract two parameters from the guided mode, the cortical thickness and the porosity index. And to this day, with our analysis, the fracture discrimination is equivalent to the gold standard, but it's still a work in progress. But this preliminary result suggests that we are able to read cortical bone markers, which are derived from guided words, which can be improved the fracture risk prediction in postmenopausal women. So for perspective, we are improving the signal processing using, for example, radar transform sparse analysis to have a better extraction of the mode. We are also improving the inverse problem using genetic algorithm and also the waveguide modeling, because now it's a free plate and the bone is not free. The soft tissue are here. And also we are doing an ex vivo study to validate the parameters, the thickness and the porosity. The thickness is quite good, and we don't know if our porosity index is really the real porosity. And how is it linked with bone strength? Okay, thank you. And there are some posters at the poster session, so if you have more detail, and if you can contact me for opportunities if you are interested. Thank you.